Scott here with Category 1 Games. This is kind of a unique item. This is a Sears 1991 wish book. Okay, so this was with Christmas season just around the corner. I thought it'd be fun to look at one of these old Sears catalogs. Now, I love these. These were really, if you can tell, the cover's even gone. I went through these a ton as a kid. I just loved these. It was so cool seeing, you know, newer technology. I mean, look at this camera. This is so cool. Fuzzy logic, right? It was just cool to see, like, all the new technology. And now, looking back, I mean, this really just shows you where we were with technology, where we were with collectibles, with, you know, fashion. It's just such a cool look back at, you know, where things were during this time period. So this is 1991. It's pretty cool to just take a look back at, like, you know, what was cool in fashion. But what really stood out to me was, like, the toys. And that's what I was really into this for, was the toys and the electronics. Now, I had a 1987 one of these, and I wish I still had it. I don't, though. So that's a bummer. But I want to just show you a few things out of this. I'm not going to go through the whole thing. Obviously, that would take forever. But I wanted to show you a few things. So first off, let's take a look at some of the Lego sets here. All right, so this is when, like, pirates had just come about, which was pretty dang cool. The Blacktron space was just coming about. And this, you know, Legos, it's cool what they're doing with Legos now and all the different brands they have as part of it. But back then, I mean, that's what you had. Like, oh man, they have pirates now? How cool is that, right? Like, that was the coolest thing. You had, like, a sports section where you could actually get signed baseballs or footballs or hockey sticks or sports cards. You know, here, get your Fleer 91 baseball set, right? The nice upper deck with the high gloss cards and the hologram for each team. The cheap tops. I mean, look at this. Like, upper decks, 47 Donruss Fleer tops. They're all 30. The tops traded was 15. I mean, so it's funny, like, you know, if you wonder what happened to the oversaturation of sports cards, and you could even get them in Sears catalogs. I mean, here's football, basketball. I can't tell you how many of these 1990 hoops basketball packs that I opened. I mean, I had just such a huge amount of those. Skybox had just come out this same time period too, which was like a cool new collecting set to collect the sports cards. So, man, so cool. But this was what was really neat to me. I was big into comics at this time, and I didn't have a huge collection, so I was 10 years old when this was out, right? 1991. I was born in 81, so I was 10, and this was a way to get a ton of comic books for really cheap, right? So this number 11 says Marvel Comics value pack here, right? It includes 25 book pack featuring Captain America, Spider-Man, all these different things. So 25 books for $12. And I mean, it was totally random, but look, you got great amount of X-Men, X-Factor, New Mutants. So I did about four or five of these during this Christmas season. I got the first appearance of Gambit this way, Uncanny X-Men 266. Like, seriously, I got the first Gambit off of doing these collector's packs, right? I got Extinction Agenda. I got all these early Jim Lee books. I mean, yeah, I got Avengers West Coast in there too, which stinks, or like Marvel Age, and you're like, eh, you know, but you got really good books as part of this. You know, all these early, like, Image guys that were in this, and it was cool. Now, DC had the same sort of thing. DC was a dollar more, and to me, the DC books were not as good. In fact, they didn't have as much of value in them as the Marvel books. These Marvel books, I mean, if you had, like, even X-Factor, Wills Portacio, his work was even up in price. Like, all these X-Men, Spider-Man, Todd McFarlane, you know, New Mutants, you had all these books where you had value in them, and you could go into a local comic shop and trade them in or sell it to them and make back more money than what you spent on this. Versus, like, DC, where you're like, oh, I got an older issue of The Flash or Superman, and those were, like, had no value at the time, right? And they cost a dollar more. So, anyways, I did that a ton. I love that. I use that a lot. Anyways, hey, anybody need a mobile phone? We got to call some people. You know, it's, like, so funny. All right, video games. Sweet. Let's look at this. So, Video games of the time were so cool. You still had these cheapo handhelds where if you didn't have the money for Game Boy, like, look, you spent $18 on one of these junky games. Can you believe that? 18 bucks? Come on. A Game Boy itself was 90 though. So, I mean, $18 or 90 for a Game Boy. You've got this huge, like, add-on light and magnifier and amplifier for your stereo. Because, yeah, you need the stereo going for your Game Boy, right? So, you've got all this cool stuff. Sorry, guys, we're tilting the camera here. You got all this cool stuff. You got all the games that it would show, like Final Fantasy Legend. Like, how much was that? Final Fantasy Legend was $35, right? So, for two of these handheld games that really didn't have much, you could buy Final Fantasy Legend, which would keep you much more entertained. You've got the Lynx for $99, which had colored games, which was really cool, like Ninja Gaiden, Rygar. I mean, it had some really good games on it. Or Game Gear, right? A Game Gear itself was $150, though. So, I mean, $190 or $150. So, I mean, that's why, you know, you wonder why Game Boy won, because it was cheap, right? And a lot of people are cheap. TurboGrafx-16, this was like the system, like, I never had seen one of these until I was an adult, right? I never saw one back in this time frame. Different games like Tailspin, $60. Or here's a CD version, right, for TurboGrafx. Pretty interesting. Sega Master System, that's funny, you could still get the Master System for $50. You know, the games were about $15 to $30, it looks like. Double Dragon for it, or you could get the Sega Genesis for $150. So it's $100 more, but the graphics were just so much better and so many more games. I mean, look at all these games for it, like Michael Jackson's Moonwalker, check that out. You get the Nintendo, just the regular Nintendo is $90. You know, people are like, man, Nintendo games, they must have cost nothing back then because the graphics weren't good. Actually, the games back then cost just about as much as games do now. Games now are, what, $50, $60? Back then, a new game was $50, $40, $50. I mean, yeah, it's like $10 cheaper. But if you wanted, like, games back then, you were still paying a lot, right? So still more Nintendo, and then Super Nintendo. This was $200. I can't remember if this was about to come out. It must have been because, look, the games are just here, like $50 for SimCity. You know, it's just funny to see this. So when people are like, man, video games are just so expensive, it's like, yeah, but they've always been expensive. Like, Atari games were even that much. We're going to skip over trains here. We'll get to action figures. Now, you can tell this page has been ripped out because I looked at it a lot. I was big into Turtles at the time. Now, check this out. You've got the Turtle playset. You got the Technodrome, which was $60. The Mutagen Mobile, I had that. Someone gave me the blimp for my birthday, and I had the sewer playset. Sewer playset was $50. How much is a blimp? Blimp was $20. You had the different figures, and they'd actually sell them in packs. So you actually bought a pack. So, like, Bad Guys pack was $17. Good Guys pack was $17. Or Storage Shell Turtles was $17 as well. Let's flip the page here and check this out. This was like the first Marvel figures. How cool was that? This is where it all started with was it Toy Biz? And so, like, over here, X-Men 4-pack number 14 was $17. Okay. Magneto Magnetron is $14. Wolverine Mutant Cycle, $14. Then they had these little sets like Wolverine Combat Cave and the Cyclops Arena, $14. You had the Goofy Wrestling figures, which were never really as cool. Or you had the Marvel Superhero Pack, right? So, like, you get the Superhero 4-pack for $16, or the other Superhero 4-pack for $16. Punisher Van was $22. Just really cool. Like, you get the Venom and the Green Goblin were sweet. Iron Man was lame. It had, like, little snap-on parts to Tony Stark. Punisher was cool. It had little pops in the back where you're like, pop, pop, pop. The Spider-Mans were just never good. They always put, like, attachments to them instead of just letting them be, like, cool figures. Let's see. Then you go on here. You've got, like, Captain Planet. Ugh, so terrible. This was Swamp Thing. You've got Robin Hood. Men in Tights. Sorry, just Robin Hood. Robin Hood playset. If you recognize that playset, number 7 here, the Sherwood Forest playset, that's actually the playset for Ewoks from Star Wars. They just reused that playset, and they actually made it better. They put trees on it. Imagine that. So if you actually want the Ewok playset, but you want a nicer version, get that version. Yeah, the Batman toys. Michael Keaton's movies were really popular at the time, and so you had this version of Batman. Except Penguin and Joker were not like how they were in the movies. And I think that was it for like the toys. You know, toys back then were kind of fading out. You didn't see any G.I. Joe or Transformers. They were on their way out. Anyways, so I just want to show you this. Like, here's popular books you can get on tape. Hey, anybody want a Bill Cosby childhood book? That should be good. That'll be a hot seller. Cameras, you know, Disney classics. Here's your VHS. I don't even think DVD was out yet. I mean, look at this. Business electronics. I mean, look at this. Bonwell Super Slim Plus laptop for $1,800. Are you kidding me? You know, like, look at these computers, like $700 for this one. You know, these were just complete crap at the time. You know, this wasn't even Windows 95. This is like Windows 3 or 1 or 3. Like, entertainment software, you had like Roger Wilco, King's Quest, you know, just different computer games, learning games, games for DOS. Where in the world is Carmen Sandiego? There we go. And then here we go. Here's our VHSs. Like, you got the Disney ones. You got like Star Trek. How much is Star Trek here? Star Trek collection, $90 for, what is that? One, two, three, Star Trek five, one through five. Ugh, can you imagine? $90 for VHS. That's so funny. You got your workout videos. I mean, they're like $19 to $30 each. I mean, it's just crazy. Here's your huge camcorders, you know, like almost $900. You know, $750, $900. I mean, it's just insane looking back at this. Let's see. I'm trying to see if there's one that actually has DVD as part of it. Is this two? Was two. VCR. These are all VCRs, right? VCRs are $350. And now check out these wood grain TVs. Don't you love this? You know, $1,800 for that 46-inch. You know, it's just so funny to look at, you know, these different things back then and think about how much technology has changed. And hey, let's put a random guy playing a saxophone on all of them. Here's different instruments. Anyways, thanks for sticking with me and watching this look back at the Sears catalog and enjoying that with me from 1991. I hope you guys are all having a great holiday season. Thanks for watching. Please continue to like our videos. Subscribe to us if you haven't already. Follow us on YouTube and Twitter. Facebook and Twitter. And help support us either on Patreon or by going to our website, category1games.com, placing some order for some cards or video games or different items there. Thanks, everyone.